Seeing a locomotive getting flown is like seeing somebody fly a house. Seeing something that weighs that much being picked up in the air kind of effortlessly, it's inspiring.
Nothing else in the world compares to this place or what we do here. I mean, we can build them from nothing, from the wheels up, frame up.
I mean, this is the place to remanufacture locomotives. And I think our people are what makes Juniata what Juniata is.
We had already prepped the engine, used a crane to set the crankshaft into place, and then we set the main caps on and bolted them into place to hold the crankshaft into place. You want to do the job, you want to do it right, you want to do it the first time.
It's kind of mind-boggling when you see a locomotive in the air, because you won't see it anywhere else unless you work here.
It's a bit intimidating at first because you see this big, huge piece of metal coming over your head. It's kind of like second nature to those people doing that job.
They need a locomotive to go to another track. They take it out onto the turntable, center it. The table moves almost like a record player. They can point it to whatever track they want it to go to, stop it there, line up the tracks, and put it on that track. That's like a big asset here. That's why we can work on so many locomotives.
Bricks and mortar you can have anywhere, but these people are multi-generational railroaders, electricians, machinists, carmen, laborers.
I'm a third generation railroader, so when you get hired here, it's kind of like a pride factor. You know, like, hey, I work at the railroad. You know, this place has been around forever. The railroad's built this country. So yeah, I do take pride in the railroad.